Two mushroom girls made a TMG pot pie.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
What's up, guys? It's Kat and Deb from Two Market Girls. Welcome back to How to Begin the Holidays, Season 4, Recipe 3, / technically 4, because we did two recipes in last video, but you know what I mean. We've moved on to the main course.
Yeah.
And what are we making today?
Mushroom pot pies.
What are you trying to eat already?
Mushroom pot pies.
That's right. Two mushroom girls made a TMG pot pie. What?
Yeah, we made pies. I don't know what else to say.
That's all there is to it. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel so you don't miss the rest of How to Begin the Holidays. And without further ado, should we just get into the... Catherine wants you to notice her shirt.
We sell merch.
Go buy merch. But let's go make the recipe.
To make your mushroom pot pie, we are first going to start off by rehydrating some shiitake mushrooms in boiling water and just letting that sit aside. To a stock pot or a Dutch oven on the stove, you're going to add some vegan butter and allow that to melt. Then we're going to add in some chopped white onion along with some minced garlic and cook that down for just a couple minutes until they just start to soften. Then we're going to add in some sliced cremini mushrooms, a diced portobello mushroom, and some shredded oyster mushrooms. And just cook that for just a couple minutes until they just start to soften. Then we're going to add in some diced carrot and diced celery. Cook that for about 5 minutes with the lid on so that it gets nice and steamed and softens everything. Then we're going to take our shiitake mushrooms that have been sitting in water for about 10 minutes now. They don't have to be perfectly soft because we're going to add them to our pot and they're gonna keep on cooking in there. So once they're soft enough to cut, you just wanna slice them up, then throw them in with the rest of the vegetables. When you slice these dehydrated mushrooms, do not get rid of the mushroom broth. We're actually going to be adding that into our pot pies after as well. And then cook that for just another couple of minutes so that everything is nice and incorporated and soft. Once everything is mixed and ready, you're going to throw in some all-purpose flour and toss it in so that you don't see any more dry flour. Then we're going to add in some soy milk along with bouillon paste and that mushroom broth. Then finally, we're going to add in some chopped thyme, sprinkle on some nutmeg and smoked paprika, and just cook that on medium heat until it's thickened just enough so that it's not like water consistency. Once that's done, you can turn off the heat and just set that aside. We are next gonna roll out our puff pastry. We want it to be about 1/4 inch thick. Then depending on what pan you're using, we're using individual portion size little pots, but you can also use a bigger pie pan if you want. You're going to place those upside down and just trace them so you have the exact size of the puff pastry that you need. So we're going to fill those pots with our filling, top it with that cutout puff pastry, and if you want, you can add some decorative touches here if you want. We just kind of added a rim of puff pastry just to give it a little bit more dimension, but you don't have to do this. Then we're going to pop it in an oven preheated to 400 degrees Fahrenheit for about 30-ish minutes until it's nice and golden brown on the top and your puff pastry looks cooked through.
Clearly, you just want to eat it because you're all ready to eat it. Oh, you ate the whole ring.
Yeah, it was really flaky looking.
So, we'll just wait. Cue elevator music. Hold music.
So good.
Now, how many different kinds of mushrooms are in this?
Four.
Four!
There's oyster mushrooms, cremini mushrooms, shiitake mushrooms, and portobello mushrooms. That's the key to a good mushroom pie. Mushrooms.
And some of them are dehydrated mushrooms that have been rehydrated. And that's like a totally different flavor of mushroom, you know what I mean?
Different flavor, different texture.
Yeah.
When you're making something that's like one note, like it's a mushroom pie. It's got other veggies and stuff in there. It's always nice to like add different types of that vegetable in it, because then you get different textures and different flavors. And because like oyster mushrooms are pretty stringy, and the dehydrated shiitakes are very meaty. Same with portobellos, but they're fresh, so they get a lot softer when you cook them.
This is really good. I'm feeling very cozy with this, you know?
Right?
It's just warming me right up.
The puff pastry cooked perfectly.
What should we talk about in the comments? Do you want to talk about savory pies?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Devin.
Yo.
Huh.
I'm not gonna eat that. Too hot!
Devin thinks savory pie is better than sweet pie. I'm like, this is great. But like, it's not better than sweet pie.
Some savory pies could be.
Okay, let's talk about your top five pies, all pies, savory and sweet. What is the best pie ever? My favorite pie is like a mixed berry fruit pie ever. I don't even think a savory pie would be on my top five at all. I'm telling you, sweet pie is better than savory pie.
That's fine. But I'm curious about more savory pies.
Yeah. Maybe I just haven't had enough savory pies in my life.
I think I haven't had enough either. You know what would be good? What? Like a savory chicken curry pie.
Mmm, that would be very good. Mm. Like the exact same way, just with chicken curry on the inside? Mm-hmm. Okay. Also, shepherd's pie is delicious.
Mmm.
But it's also one of those different pies, because it's potatoes.
Yeah. Can you tell us about savory pies that we need to try?
I don't think there's ever going to be a savory pie that gets into my top five pies ever. But I would love to be proven wrong.
Yeah, I want to find that pie.
It has, like, so, for context, mixed berry pie, or, like, a summer harvest pie, pumpkin pie, cranberry hand pie, so we make specifically, lemon meringue pie, and then the five is still kind of up for grabs.
You really only care about four pies.
Yeah. Four main pies I care about are those pies. But, like, blueberry pie's great, cherry pie's great. The only...
She's naming my list now.
Yeah. The only pies that I don't... that I don't like is apple pie, like regular apple pie. But I don't know if this is a pie yet or not, but like the apple crumble that actually has a pie shell base, is that a pie?
I think it's a hybrid, so like, I don't know if it should count.
I've had pies like that before, so I don't know if it's like an apple crumble pie or if, I don't know. But like that would make it onto the list if it's considered a pie.
Okay.
But yeah, like I only really care about four pies. They're the only main pies I eat. And I just can't imagine savory pie ever beating any of those pies.
I believe you, but I just want to explore savory pies.
Okay, let's explore savory pies.
Let's do it. In the comments, we're exploring savory pies. As usual, the recipe will be linked in the description box below. There's also a link to our podcast. It's called TMG Unfiltered.
No way.
We've been on it a few times. You should remember.
Sometimes. I have been a guest
sometimes,
before.
Yes. We talk about things like veganism. We talk about how we make our recipes, how we run our blog.
We run a news show.
Yes, we do the news. Lots of stuff to talk about. Go check it out. It's on Spotify. It's on Apple Podcasts. It's on Google Play.
It's everywhere.
Everywhere that you get your podcasts from.
Yep.
Also in the description box is a link to these beautiful sweaters that we made for you.
They're not ours. They're just, you know, you should buy them.
Yeah, we just really like them. So we think that you would like them too.
We're their spokespeople.
Yeah, we are influencers for this brand.
You should buy this shirt.
Why are we being so weird?
It also comes in t-shirt form, if you want a t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
We also have two other designs. We have Camber Eats First and something else.
Does this shirt look vegan?
That one.
So but go check that out. Link is in the description.
Go buy some, because we'd love to do more designs, but we want to make sure you guys want more designs, right?
Otherwise, we're just making them for ourselves.
Because that's literally all that is happening.
But we're not mad about it, because we wear these all the time.
I actually wear this all the time.
Me too. I get home from work, and I immediately change into this.
Yeah.
Oh!
Follow us on Instagram.
Because we're giving away
stuff. We got a lot of free product we're just giving away because we're such nice people.
And if you haven't been following along already, you've missed some really good stuff.
You've missed some amazing things.
So, sorry about that.
But, you still have a bunch of stuff to win. There's still great opportunities to win. Each product is, like, open to different areas, so keep an eye on the small print. Also, you want to follow us now so that you don't miss it next year again. Because obviously we're going to do it as many years as we
just want to give away nice stuff that we like.
Yeah. It's our time to give back to you guys as a thank you for supporting us.
Mm-hmm.
Share some of our favorite products lately. All the kind of stuff that might be able to help you in your life. like lunch boxes.
Live your best life. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go for the day.
Oh god, we're so annoying.
Oh, there goes what the hell are we doing? Third time's a charm. That's what I'm trying to say.
Were the other ones not good?
Ugh.
Oh no. You sound like a shark that's hungry. I'm so full though. I ate like half a tray of scalloped potatoes.
Pretty close.
I basically just ate like four potatoes.